Gonna do it. Hello and welcome to the Gamer Just Duel podcast number 33. I did it. I was just sitting. I'm pretty sure I said I'm gonna do it about 10 to 20 times before I actually did it. We've been sitting here and I've just been stalling because I really want to eat, but I also want to do the podcast. But like, it's got to be done on Sunday because I gotta get the rendering done and things so that it's up on Monday. But I'm really hungry. Anyways, I'm really hungry. After this, I'm just craving some honeycombs. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Honeycombs are legit. They're
pretty good.
They're a good cereal.
You don't even need sugar or anything. You just put them in a bowl with milk and it's good.
Yeah, freaking sugar. Do you commonly put sugar on your cereal?
Oh, well, on like flake stuff.
Interesting.
Like, I'll put it on like, I'll put it on Raisin Bran because sometimes they don't put enough sugar on it. So
yeah, that's a good cereal. If I were ever to put sugar on one cereal, it'd be Raisin Bran. Or just some lame cornflakes or something.
Yeah.
Anyways, we are an entertainment podcast that focuses on video games, PlayStation,
cereal.
Destiny, and cereal. also Xbox, but not as much because, reasons.
Raisins.
Raisin Bran. I'm one of your hosts, TB Stack, but you can call me Teddy. And this is Eric.
Hello.
And he loves you.
Legend PvM. Yeah.
You're like, yeah, I guess so. That's cool. So, Eric, normally we start off with what we've been playing, but I also, this week, I should have talked to you about this before we started, but hello. This week, I want to go back. I just hit a key on my keyboard and it did the Windows 10 echo. This week I want to go back to the old school, the retro style where we talk about what we've been playing and what we've been watching, because we haven't talked about TV much because we don't have our shows anymore. So I want to talk about what's been going on in our world of, you know, viewing things with our eyeballs. So, what have we been playing? It's been a week, but it feels like it's been 2 weeks. It really does. It feels like it's been 2 weeks since the last time we've done a podcast, at least for me. So, we've been playing multiple things.
Yeah.
Freaking last Monday was when we sat down and did Halo 2 and finished Halo, and then got
Halo 3
through the same amount of missions, and then we did we beat Halo 3 that night, or did we go back another night and finish? I can't remember.
I think we went back. Yeah, we stopped, and then we beat the last two missions.
Yeah. So So we did that. Now we only have
ODST
and Halo 4.
Halo 4, and then Reach when backward compatibility comes out.
Which is, spoilers for our upcoming news, might as well just say it now. It's coming in November. What? It's coming in November. But they will also discuss that there's a list of confirmed backwards compatible games, and then some rumored ones. So we'll go over some highlights there in the future. The future.
Or you could scrub.
This is true. I mean, and then pretty much the present, but
yeah.
It's the future, all right. Just stay here, all right. Just stay here. So nice. We played Halo. We played Destiny last night. Played that freaking Trials of Osiris because Brother Vance is selling, freaking helmets, which is amazing.
Yeah, it is amazing.
It's really great.
The helmets for a while.
We're gonna sit down and do it even more soon. We all have...
Maybe tonight.
Yeah, maybe tonight, and if
I
not
just want
tonight,
the helmet,
tomorrow.
At least. I don't mind not going...
To be honest, we could have easily gone flawless. Like, easily. Ryan did. Like, we basically did. We just had tech problems. We had tech problems, and you didn't have your boon. So if you had your boon, Ryan's internet... Well, no, you didn't get...
I went to Brother Vance, and
you
wasn't selling it.
Oh, well, but you... The point is, you didn't have the one that gave you the two wins on your first win. So, like, if you had that, and if Ryan hadn't have disconnected that one game, we would have We would have freaking had Flawless. Like it
because we were doing good.
Yeah, it wasn't that hard. But yeah, Trials is great. I'm trying to think of what things we played together. Other than that, we played. Did we do? No, we didn't do Skolas. I think me, Ryan, and Andrew did Skolas last week.
We did Skolas a week or two ago.
Yeah, we did Skolas.
Got our other stuff. We talked about that last week.
Yeah, so that was 2 weeks ago.
Good times.
Yeah, good times. I don't know. I think that's it for what we've played together. I also we freaking downloaded Sound Shapes. Eric's been playing that for the first time. Sound Shapes is great, and it's free on PS Plus right now. You should download it. Also, Limbo's there. Download that.
Limbo, I already beat it in like an hour.
Also,
I do all the puzzles.
Stealth Inc. 2 is really good and is there.
Downloaded.
The other one is
Lara Croft
and the Temple of Osiris. Speaking of Osiris, sorry. Osiris is everywhere, mate. He's also in Halo.
Yeah,
he's also in Halo. Freaking Osiris too. He's everywhere. So I think that's mostly it for what I've been playing. I can't remember anything else. Lots of Destiny, mainly because of this Destiny news. Lots of Destiny. Oh yeah,
ridiculous amount.
What else have you been playing throughout the week? Anything solo?
I mean, I played some, mostly just, I played a lot of just Crucible.
Yeah.
I mean, I played Limbo. Yeah. I beat it. I wanted to go for the Platinum, but one of the trophies that I didn't get was not dying more than 5 times. Which I can see being possible if you know all the puzzles, but some of the puzzles are just, they're jerks, and yeah.
And, you know, you kind of, like, if you screw that up, it's like, well, start over the whole game. Mm-hmm. So that's
a, I mean, the game isn't that long, it's just...
Yeah, I get you. But, yeah, that's, you can do it, though. I believe in you. You can do it.
Probably.
You can do it. You should, because... I don't know. A lot of us have, like, a Platinum that we really is, like, our own. Andrew has, you know, 20 of those. And then I think you should have Limbo as, like, your own thing. Ryan has Aether 1. I have Second Son because I think I consider that as mine because freaking Second Son is, like, one of my favorite games. But, yeah, you should do Limbo. And also Bloodborne because you're actually really close to that.
I only need 2 more.
I brought that up just because every time you think of that, you're like, man, I only need 2 more. Every time and you're like, sucks. Dang.
No, it's because one of the trophies is to kill the Thumerian Queen, which you have to go through, like, this one chalice dungeon, which your health is halved, and everything's really hard on top of it. So it's like, yeah, that's, I don't know if I want to do that.
Health is halved. That's crazy. Yep. Yeah, so I don't know. I don't think I played anything else. Friggin' Destiny.
That's interesting.
I should also do that. So there is a lot of news because Gamescom happened. Most of the news,
and because Game Informer is a thing. That's also another source. Yeah,
sure.
Stuff's going on.
A lot of the Gamescom news is mostly Xbox, but. You know, there's some other stuff. There was one thing I freaking found. You know, let's talk about this as the first thing. There was one thing. You know, usually when I compile the topics, I go to IGN, I go to some other news outlets like Kotaku and Polygon stuff, but I don't usually come up with anything from them. No offense. I need to start looking at GameSpot more often because they have some good stuff. But anyways, one thing that I just found, I was scrolling, usually on IGN I go to the top 5 news of the week to remind me what happened, and then I just scroll through the past 7 days. Freaking, this just slipped under the radar. Battleborn got a release date. Just happened, and I didn't even know. So before they were saying Christmas or winter of 2015, nope. February 9th. Which is like, it's fine, you know, push your game if you have to. But they were just saying not of 2015. And I think they were saying
technically it's still winter.
not of 2015. Because you're in 2016.
I mean, it's the same winter that was started in 2015, so.
But it was continued in 2016.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The same winter. So it's 2015's winter.
I see what you're saying.
2015 owns that winter. I'm just trying to come up with something. So.
Yeah. So Battleborn, February 9th, 2016. If you were looking out at that, there you go. I was, but I freaking slipped under the radar right there. It happened in a Gamescom trailer where they showed off a couple of new characters, and then it was just like, at the end, well, there's the release date.
Have you had any news about Blizzard's shooter?
There was a couple of things that was like, Overwatch releases a new character, and that was it.
Why are we supposed to care when we don't know anything about the game?
And the game's not out yet. Like, yeah. They keep like showing off new heroes and whatnot, and I'm like, what? I don't know. I'll do a quick search, but I don't
know what this does to the game. What does this do for the game?
I don't think there was anything like that was like a release window or anything, because there may be a release window for that game, but I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
That game's gonna be great, but nobody knows when it's coming out. And I was thinking about this the other day. I really hope that they don't do what they did for Heroes of the Storm, which was like alpha or closed alpha or closed alpha, closed beta, yeah. Open beta release, which is fine. But like by the time the actual release came out, we had played a lot of the games, so it was like, what could they have really changed?
Get back in Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah, they're constantly the maps, doing stuff for that.
It's like one MOBA where I'm like excited to have multiple maps.
Yeah. They have a purpose for all the multiple maps.
Yeah, because they each have different mechanics.
Definitely not just cosmetic. I'm going to type in Overwatch release window.
I think the one map on Heroes of Storm where you go like underground into a mine. Do you remember that? You have to kill all those things to collect some something.
Yeah, that one's super unique.
That was really cool.
So, I have ads going on right now. This site is just all full of ads right now. It's scrolling my screen randomly. Let's see. Dang it. This is an article from January 7th of 2015 that says Overwatch release date update. Open beta set for May 2015.
What?
That's not true. That's not true at all. Obviously not. Overwatch beta confirmed at BlizzCon. That happened, I remember that, but that was forever ago. Yeah, there's nothing about it. It's gonna happen one day. One day there's just gonna be something, or if Blizzard is Blizzard, they'll just randomly be like, open beta tomorrow. Look out for that. Free and Overwatch. I think that game is, if they handle that well, I think that game could be ginormous.
Yeah.
Freaking huge. Do you want to know some of the games that are confirmed for backwards compatibility?
Yeah. Because I think it's kind of cool. After that, we can go into the next thing about X-Bone stuff.
The X-Bone. The good old X-Bone with its good old UI and freaking connections on that Master Chief collection.
It's gonna get a better UI, so.
Master Chief Collection still broken.
That is incredible to me. I mean, you saw it with your eyes.
It's incredible that it's so much war. Like, it's so much better than it used to be. Like, imagine that. You know,
I think back then they couldn't even connect.
Yeah. So let's see. I'm gonna go over key stuff here. You know, Gears of War, Gears of War 2, Gears of War 3, Gears of War Judgment.
Halo Reach.
Not on this list, actually. I saw it on another list, but this
I saw
is
it on
IGN's
a photo
list.
Of backwards compatibility coming.
Oh yeah, I did too. What are they doing with this list, IGN? What the frick are you doing? Anyways, I'm pretty sure all the Halos like that were on 360, like Halo 3, Halo 4, Halo Reach, ODST. I saw those. Viva Pinata, I have heard so much about that freaking game. I don't understand, but I'm going to play it on the replay.
I've played it. The Viva Pinata game, it's charming because it's kind of like a Sims game, only you're working with these,
that sounds amazing.
Pinata, you're working with these pinata dogs and animals and stuff. Yeah, and I've, you can.
I've just heard that it's actually really good. Like, it's a really good game.
I think I remember, like, when you're breeding, like you can like breed, caterpillar pinatas.
Heck yes.
And like the way it works is that you have to get the caterpillars to eat the apple. And then there's like a weird scene with them like squeaking or something.
That's amazing. I gotta get on that hilarious. On the Rare Replay.
It's interesting. So, yeah.
Also, I bought the Rare Replay and I played that a little bit. That's one thing I played last week.
Did you play again?
I started Conkers.
Conker, yeah.
But freaking.
It's hilarious.
Conker. The problem with the most of these games and what I was scared about is that they were going to control awfully. I can deal with some old stuff, but if it controls just like I can't do it. It's so... Oh, and I even saw somebody tweeting about it. It was like, Conker's bad fur day controls like a bad nightmare. Yeah. But I was like, yo.
Conker's bad controller day.
Pretty much. But yeah, there's some others throughout that the Rare Replay that are actually like more recent, that aren't like Conker's was like a N64 game. I'm pretty sure.
It was very old.
The Xbox 360 arcade. So yeah. I'm sure there are ones newer than that that I can try out, but I definitely want to try out freaking Viva Pinata, mate. Freaking breeding caterpillars, feeding them apples. Heck yes.
It's hilarious.
So, speaking of the Xbox, I just wanted to toss this out there. If we were actually more knowledgeable about things, we would, like, watch the trailer and discuss this and blah, blah, blah. But we're not really. And also, we don't have all the time in the world to watch all these trailers and to play all these games. So, we're not ingrained in the Xbox culture like I am with PlayStation. Eric pretty much is with PlayStation. So, like, we're not, like, in that culture with Xbox at the moment. Eric's like on in both of them.
I'm just here.
So I don't like I like all these games. I imagine like these games that are like have sequels and whatnot from Gamescom for the Xbox. I imagine are like PlayStation's little niche games like Infamous and freaking Sound Shapes and a bunch of other and Uncharted and God of War and stuff like that. So like only but a little more niche of those. Like so only these are games that like hardcore Xbox fans were really looking forward to, but as somebody who like not really too into the Xbox economy is like I've heard of this, but like, you know, I don't fully know what it is. I never played the previous, blah blah blah. I skimmed through some stuff about them. They look really cool. So I just want to toss this out there. We need to keep an eye on these three games. There's others, but these three were like the ones that stuck out to me as like, haven't really heard too much about it, but they look awesome.
Yeah.
And a lot of Xbox people are talking about Crackdown 3, Scalebound, and Quantum Break all look really, really dope.
See, I like what I've seen about Quantum Break.
Yeah, that looks really cool.
But I haven't seen anything about Scalebound.
Scalebound is a platinum game.
He had a headset on. That looks cool.
An action RPG. It's platinum. You know, platinum are the people who do Bayonetta and Korra, and they're doing an RPG, but most likely with like their own very actiony fighting, which is cool.
Yeah,
and Quantum and Crackdown looks interesting.
I played Crackdown 2 when it was on. It was on Games with Gold, and I got free. So I played it. I played it a little bit, and
apparently Crackdown 1's better.
It's like a ridiculous. It's kind of like. It reminds me of Saints Row.
Yeah.
In terms of ridiculousness, but like it's not as vulgar, I should say.
Yeah.
I feel it's like very arcadey.
Yeah,
I don't know what I think
of
it. Which is cool. So.
The main thing that they were talking about there interesting. But the main thing that they were talking about there was like that I found very impressive was that they were talking about that they were using the cloud as part of the gaming like system. So they were basically like using the cloud and adding it as part of like processing power for the city that they're in. So like you can destroy pretty much the whole city.
Yeah.
Because of the cloud, which is cool. They explain it better than that.
But, interesting.
Yeah. So it's you can pretty much just destroy the whole city if you wanted to, which I was like, all right, you know, might get that just to destroy a city and then you know, move on. So yeah, we need to keep an eye on that. As out of those three, Scalebound is probably the one that I'm looking at the most. But then again, I watched a trailer for Quantum Break. It looks a little bit Infamous-y. So I might be down on that.
Yeah.
But yeah.
All right, let's while we're on the topic of Xbox, might as well talk about Gears of War here.
Oh yeah. This was the first piece of news from last week. This is what happened
this
on
this made
like,
me really
Monday.
Happy.
Yeah.
I saw that and
this happened like Monday morning or like Sunday night, like after we finished or something. And then I was like, oh, all right.
Yeah, it was Monday morning because I remember waking up and seeing it in the Facebook, you know, the trending.
Yeah.
Facebook trending. So, yeah, Gears of War is coming, or the Ultimate Edition. So it's like a remake of the first one, and then all the other ones are coming with it, I think.
The backwards compatible. The 360 versions of all the others are coming with it.
Okay, so awesome. you'll like you say if you got the physical version of the.
That's Ultimate a good Edition, question. I don't know how the
three
physical
games
works.
Or four games.
Yeah, you'll probably just get like download codes for the other three.
Yeah.
If I were to guess, they're not gonna give you like three boxes. That's like here you go. But
well, yeah, that's what I would assume. Yeah,
I'm actually pretty sure that that's how all backwards compatibility works on the Xbox. So yeah, there's that, which is awesome because I was like, I freaking pre-ordered Gears of War Ultimate Edition, but isn't that gonna be your first pre-order when you get your paycheck?
I got it last Friday.
Oh, you got your paycheck last Friday. I've already gotten. Oh yeah, what'd you get? Because you were gonna go through the list and do like the ones
I
that are coming
two
most
things.
Recently.
No, I actually only got one.
So
I got Taken King.
Oh okay.
I'm probably just gonna go down the list.
Yeah.
What's next?
I think Gears is next on the list. Gears is most recent because it's August 25th. Let me open it up.
Hold on a second. August 25th, really?
Yeah. That's what we said last time, and you were like, dang, I gotta get on that. It's actually the most recent.
I need to charge my phone, but dang, I didn't realize it was...
Yeah, it's like 2 weeks from now, pretty much. Yeah.
All right, then.
2 weeks from Tuesday.
I'll get on that, then.
Yeah, just do it! Do it! Sorry. My inner Shia LaBeouf decides to come out from time to time.
Well, I need to find your link with all the games.
Hey, I'll send it to you real quick. But... that's awesome, because I got Gears of War Ultimate Edition that was kind of like, eh. Like, it's cool that I'll get to play the first game, and it'll look nice, and it'll be 1080p, but, like, at the same time, I was like, I'm going to have to go back and repurchase all the other ones and play them when it comes out for backwards compatibility, which is what I was planning on doing. I was planning on playing the first one through the Ultimate Edition, then when it comes out for backwards compat, I was just going to like, all right, let me just buy all these cheap on Amazon, but then... I don't have to, so
yeah,
I'm gonna be able.
With the Ultimate Edition.
Yeah,
great.
I can get caught up for Gears 4 in 2016, which is awesome.
Probably, yeah. All right. Yeah. Okay. Like I played Gears 1, and I got like halfway through 2. I own 2, I haven't opened it at all. I have played halfway through it, and. Yeah, I have the complete collection. I have all the DLC too. I got this from a friend that didn't want it anymore.
Thanks.
It's like brand new. It's brand new. It has a Fable 2 thing in it. This is hilarious.
Brand new as in years old, but hasn't been opened.
Yeah, it's been opened once.
It's been preserved. I feel like you've kept the dust off of it and whatnot by just opening, by like grabbing it every now and then, being like, oh, look at this, I still have this, and then putting it back.
I have a box for all my games.
Yeah. All right. Well, there you go.
You're going to laugh earlier about this other game that I have, but.
Oh, man.
When we get to that.
Can that be your show and tell?
Yeah, it can.
All right.
But it's part of our topic, so.
Oh, fancy. speaking of Xbox, guess what else is coming to the Xbox One?
What's that?
Halo 5, boy.
Yeah. Boom, 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 boom. Obviously not coming to PC. Rip.
Never. I thought it was funny. When, yeah, sure. But whenever you said that, you were like, I hope it comes to Windows 10. I was like, it's no way. There's no way. There's no freaking way that's going to happen. If that ever happens, it'll be like 20 years down the road.
No, when, it's basically the Half-Life. When Half-Life 3 releases, there we go.
Yeah. Pretty much. All right. Well, I'm at zero.
Yeah, me too.
3, 2, 1, play. This is actually really cool. It. We can talk over it because it's not really story. It's just showing gameplay. Yeah, I'm lowering my sound a little bit.
Yeah, it's lower too.
It's just.
I've seen this, but yeah,
it's a multiplayer trailer, which is cool for the people watching. It's basically just showing off. I thought it was cool that this trailer basically just goes like two distinct styles: Warzone, and then Arena.
That map looked right there. It was really cool looking.
And then Arena, like. That's awesome.
Like, it looks like Arena, too. Like, specific arenas.
Yeah, I'm very excited for this.
In Halo 4, they put lore behind the multiplayer. So I'm guessing that's what they're doing here.
Oh, that headshot, son!
Headshot. Oh!
That's a double kill! Oh!
The SMG looks so good.
This is all looking real good. There. Combat has evolved. Self-reference. I just thought it was very interesting that it was like that they were showing it as like Warzone and Arena.
Yeah.
Like there's two distinct. I thought Warzone would be like, you know, like the playlist that's on the Master Chief Collection. It'd be like Slayer, King of the Hill, blah blah blah. Warzone. But it looks like there's going to be... Maybe there'll be Warzone, and then separate different game modes within Warzone.
The truth, and it's like killing me. I want more of that.
Oh, man. But that's going to happen. You know what? I'll find a date right now. Not the truth season 2 release date. Because there is a release date.
Around the same date it get releases or something.
No. It's like August something, mate. I'm almost positive. Wait, I think I just saw something.
Okay, I'm just gonna point this out. It's a really good point, but in terms of hating, no, it's not. So there's someone talking about how 343 has designed the Spartan 4s, where they look all chunky and plastic. And there's a reason for that is because they're newer Spartans. They're Spartan 4s, not Spartan 2s, like Chief and Blue Team. Especially Team Osiris, they're all like fresh awesome. Spartans. So.
They look awesome. Season 2 awesome. Of Halo's popular Hunt the Truth audio season series will launch this fall. Man, this doesn't give me a release date. Gosh dang it. They fooled me with this title. It says September. Anyway, it's going to happen soon. So keep an eye on that. Is there anything else Xbox related on here, actually?
Yes, there is.
There is? Would you look at that?
The bottom in mine.
Yeah. Freaking, do you know about this, mate? Do you know about this? Oh my gosh, he does know about
this. Do you see this, though?
Oh my goodness. I thought that you would have experience here, right? But nope.
Oh, I do. Yeah, I've played this several times.
Well, then why do you have it?
Because I need to play it because there's apparently a good story in it. But another reason
but
I haven't played it...
you said you already did play it. You said I've played it multiple times.
The demo, and I've played like 30 minutes of the campaign.
You literally just said, oh, dude, I've played it multiple times. Like a bunch.
Yeah,
that's
multiple
not,
times
that doesn't
for like
count.
30 minutes.
That doesn't count.
Yeah, I know. Oh, it doesn't count.
Dang.
The reason I haven't played it yet is because it has co-op. And hearing about the
backwards compatibility, you were just like, oh.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think Halo Wars 2 is like a 2016 thing. So, yeah. So there you go. We can play this in 2015 when we're, you know, not being sucked away.
Would
by
this work
Fallout
though,
and Destiny.
On my.
Yeah. The way it's supposed. The way it's it supposed to work. Oh, my. Gosh, dang it. The way it's supposed to work is that you. Slip in a disc, slip it in, you know.
It reads into, okay, you get to download this.
Yes. It's like you have this game and we'll download it for you. It doesn't play it off of the disc.
Okay.
But yeah, you'll be able to. You won't have to buy.
This means I'll need a better hard drive.
yes, you will. But external hard drives. So
GeForce. Wait, that works.
Pretty sure, almost positive. Almost. All right. I haven't tried it out, but I'm like 99% on this one, which is cool.
99 problems, but a hard drive is one.
Not for me.
Actually, do you have a terabyte MCC?
No.
Like,
no.
Okay.
Did you get a terabyte?
No, okay. I almost did, but then the tax was too much.
Yeah, it's, you know, I was like, nah. Especially if it supported an external, because I have one right here. That's like, I think, 2 terabytes.
You can just plug it into the side. That little USB on the left side, you know?
Yeah. So, yeah.
That's not USB, is it?
Oh, yeah, it is. I use it for my controller. Halo Wars 2 is coming to Xbox One and Windows 10 in fall 2016. Fall 2016, so we have a whole year. But yeah, what's funny is that they're because the original studio who did Halo Wars got shut down, which I think is funny. I think it's weird because they apparently, like, Xbox or Microsoft came to them and was like, when you release this game, we're shutting you down. Like, while they were working on the game. They're like, once this game's out, you guys are gone. So they were like, okay. But, yeah, so their studio's gone. They were released in 2009. But everyone really liked the game. So Phil Spencer, the savior of Xbox, swooped in and was like, you know what, we're freaking going to do this. So let's see if I can find the actual studio who's doing Halo Wars 2. Creative Assembly. They're the studio who do Total War. Have you heard of that? Yeah.
Wait, it's like, seriously?
Yeah, Total War. And like, I think
they're known for their strategy.
I think they are actually under Sega, which is very weird. Yeah. Oh. So it's gonna be like a Sega team doing an Xbox game, which is cool. It's all very very cool. I like
that. That makes me kind of excited because they're known for their strategy games.
Yeah. So. Yeah, but I also saw an article somewhere that was like Halo Wars 2 won't be Total War Halo, you know, which is cool. I like when other studios take on and they're not going to make it.
Because I like the format that Halo Wars was in.
Yeah.
It was more personalized rather than you have giant armies, push them that way.
Yeah. And the same is, you know, it's like with Star Wars Battlefront, where everyone was like, don't be Battlefield : Star Wars, you know, which is what everyone was, like, worried about. And it
doesn't look anything like
besides that's maybe good.
The engine.
So it gives me hope for that developers who have been working on a big franchise for so long can just be like, you know what, no. And just turn around, do other different stuff.
Yeah.
It's cool. I think that's all of the Xbox stuff we have, actually. That was, there we go.
Because Blops 3.
Yeah, I want to talk about this quick. So Xbox we can, I want to talk about this quick so we can move on to Destiny. Because we need to talk about Destiny for like 20 minutes. Let's blow through the three pieces we have before Destiny that we just talked about Destiny. So I want to freaking talk about this Black Ops 3 thing. Let me find the correct links. Here's one of the links. Here's another. Okay, so Black Ops 3, this is really cool. I just saw this when I was going through the info. Von der Haar is one of like the biggest supporters of esports for first-person shooters and for Call of Duty. That's why Black Ops 2 had like specific spectator and different modes like that so that anyone could do it. But this time they're going even further, and like I say that every single FPS shooter should have, aka Destiny, they're having an arena ranked mode. Which is very simple. It's kind of like League, where, like, you win, you move up in the ranks. You lose, you move down in the ranks. Yeah. But they're apparently developing a system, because what people used to do in systems like this, people would, like, be really good, and then, like, intentionally lose to drop back down to the ranks to play against awful people and just, like, slay. So what they're trying to do to prevent against that is, like, you have to lose two games to drop back down and stuff, and they're also, like, putting in their own system and stuff. There's actually some more details in this article that wasn't in the video.
Is there prestiges and all that stuff?
Oh, well, there's probably prestiges and in general in the multiplayer, but they don't really matter.
Eh.
Probably not.
Wish it would do something. So
I'm glad that they one game they didn't. I can't remember which one it was. I think it might have been Black Ops 2 actually, but one of them there wasn't.
Prestige Master was the ending.
Yeah.
Prestige 4.
One of them there wasn't, or either there wasn't, or there was a very small, you know, number. It wasn't like 15 prestige.
Yeah, I know. Like, there was like 5 or something.
Yeah, which it's like, all right, it's cool, getting better, but I have a lot of faith in a different ranking system. I love it. I think it's perfect, except for Prestige.
Exactly.
I think the exact Prestige, like leveling like, thing, but
I like
Prestige
leveling up
is not necessary
more stuff.
In any way at all. Like you don't have to Prestige. I never do. I Prestige back
but I want
when.
To.
Well, that's your problem, mate. You're just screwing yourself over there. No one's forcing you to Prestige.
Well, I mean, as long as I can get. Keep a gun that I enjoy. I mean, it's okay, but I just would rather be able to rank up and keep going along, but with all my weapons. I don't know.
Yeah, I never like Prestige, which is why I never do it. I do it on games that I really enjoy, like Black Ops 1 and MW3, where I was playing a bunch. I Prestiged once, and then got to max again, and then was like, alright, cool.
I'll tell you this.
Just have one Prestige.
Back when I played a lot of MW2, even though, like, Black Ops 2 was out, I played, like, so much since... That was, like, the most Call of Duty I played was MW2, but... we ran into some guys, and, like, when you shoot them and kill them... when you kill them...
Yeah.
It would give you a prestige. And basically...
Oh, my gosh.
You just keep playing, like... You would just be doing a game... You kill them, you get a prestige. You kill another one. Oh, now you're prestige 5. Kill another one. And in one game, I went from prestige 3 to 8.
What the heck?
So now on Xbox, on MW2, I am now prestige 8 because of some,
that's
some
hilarious.
Hackers or whatever.
It's
funny, but...
That's pretty great. But weird. That's freaking weird.
It's really weird. I didn't lose any guns or anything, too.
So. Yeah. So, yeah, they're trying to... Maybe they're... Freaking Vonderhaar's trying to prevent boosting and stuff like that. So there you go. Maybe there won't be as much of that. But
yeah.
I also watched some gameplay while I was looking at this. And it honestly looks really good. They're blending what I like, personally, about Advanced Warfare and the Exo. And they're making it just slower. They're like,
yeah.
You don't boost as much. There's like a visual boost cooldown, so like you can use it to either go up as in a jetpack or like to the side. It's kind of just a little bit more height in
right,
whatever
like
direction.
It's like a replacement for a ladder. That's what I've heard.
Yeah, it's not necessarily
a maneuverable.
Yeah, it's not like a dodging.
Yeah, because sometimes like I mean.
It's looking real nice.
If you got the hang of the boost in Advanced Warfare, it was all right.
Yeah.
But like sometimes you just be shooting on someone and then they go and you're like, okay.
Yeah. Also, I just really love rank systems in any Call of Duty. Like first person shooter. I really just like that there are ranks and that you can like in freaking you know in other games you just when I was younger and playing Call of Duty, it's just like, hey, I'm leveling up. But when I got older, I was like, I kind of want to move up a ranking ladder when I started playing League and realizing what was going on there. I was like, this would be perfect in a first-person shooter, because while I'm leveling up, I can also, like, get on with my team.
You know how, like, simple
That's
it would be
to Destiny
add a rank system with Destiny?
I know! I've been saying
be
this
so neat, like,
since
and
launch.
Functional.
I've been saying this since launch, man.
It would be, like, I don't know, Skirmish and then Clash.
You remember this. I have been saying this since launch. Like, when the game came out, and it, like, I've been saying it, like, 2 weeks after the game was out, I was like, man, they really need this. And I went on about it for, like, 3 months. And then I just eventually just gave up, because I'm like, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Another awesome thing about Black Ops 3 that is getting me really excited and, like, showing me, dude, there's freaking hope for this game, especially when it comes to rank stuff. Let's just read this paragraph here. Before a competitive match, players will enter a ban and protect phase. Two players at a time, one from each team, will be able to protect or ban any score streaks, weapons, specialists, or abilities. This feature will, for example, allow players to ban weapons they know their enemies are skilled with, or to ensure they won't be stripped of their own. AKA League of Legends esports.
Yeah.
Just tossing that out there. Like, it's what, like, all MOBAs do this. There's a ban phase. There's not, like, a ban of protect, but right. That's unique to, like, a first-person shooter with, like, weapons and stuff. But this is looking real good. That's a real, real good thing to add right there. I'm looking forward to trying that out. So there's that. Dota 2 Internationals happened.
Oh, my gosh. So, apparently, Gabby and Jared went to Ignite Gaming Lounge just to watch it with a bunch of people.
Yeah. Huh.
Thought that was interesting.
I thought that was awesome. I saw that. I was like, that's so cool. But, yeah, so freaking guess who won? You would never guess this. It's a MOBA. Who won? Who would you think? Just thinking, oh, it's a MOBA. Oh, it's the freaking internationals of a MOBA. I wonder what nation's going to win. And then you automatically think, Korea. But no! It didn't happen this time. What the frick? Step up your game, League of Legends. What are you doing over here, NA? What's going on? They can do it over there in Dota. Why can't we?
Yeah.
But yeah. I just thought that was interesting. I heard that, like, it's like EG, Evil Geniuses. But I heard that, and I was like, I heard that, and I was like, wait, what? Did they must have just won, like, a preliminary thing, right? And I was like,
no, they won the 66 million.
I was like, and then I started looking into it more, and I was like, wait, no, this can't be right. Are they really U.S.? Maybe they're, like, European or something. Let me look. Oh, my gosh. No, they're legitimately just a U.S. team. It shocked me, dude, because every time for, like, 2 years
I watched Worlds.
Maybe that
means it's more balanced.
What?
I
for,
like, no
2 years, I watched Worlds for LCS, and every time – NA had no chance. No one had any chance. Like, they can't touch the Koreans because they're so good. Like, it's they're untouchable. And then Dota is apparently not the same. So, USA, USA, chant. All right. So, Eric, we have one more topic before we can talk about Destiny.
And it is World of Warcraft.
WoW, as some call it.
Yeah, wow. But yeah, the Burning Legion is back in the realm of, I don't know what the realm is. I'm guessing
In the new expansion. If they announced that
Gamescom. But yeah, the Burning Legion is coming back, and the leaders of, or the main characters, I guess, in the lore and such are freaking out because they were there in the Burning Crusade, obviously. Which was apparently upheld as one of the greatest expansion of all of them.
Yeah.
So.
I've heard that. So yeah, the freaking World of Warcraft expansion. I don't have much to say about this except for that.
Neither do
I'm excited to see the cinematic trailer when it happens. That'll be cool.
When I saw this announcement, the first thing that was, well, I mean, actually, I was excited that they're releasing an actual new class, because they haven't done that in a while. Yeah.
It's called the Demon Hunter.
Which is pretty cool, and they have some pretty cool looks to them. But, like, and they also have this artifact thing, so, like, pretty much exotic weapons.
So, Eric, I just thought of something. This is completely off track from WoW. We'll get back to it in a second. But freaking, you know how we were saying that we were going to talk about what we've been watching? I just now remember that.
Yeah.
We didn't. It didn't happen. Right. I was just, like, sitting here, and I was like, wait a minute. So, yeah.
You watched episodes of Star Wars The Clone Wars.
Real quick. I want to get back to watching more TV. That's why I wanted to talk about that. So I have been... I'm going to finish the shows that I'm currently in, which is Star Wars, and then go back and finish the two episodes of Doctor Who. Doctor Who Season 8 is on Netflix. Just tossing that out there. So I'm going to binge Star Wars. One of my days off, I'm going to watch, like, just most of the day. I'm going to sit down and do it. So... I'm going to finish Star Wars, then I'm going to go to Doctor Who and watch a bunch of other stuff, some things. You'll know about it when I'm done. And I was curious if you've been watching anything. Like, we play a lot of games, and yeah. Before this, like, proactive decision, I was just, like, basically playing games and not watching anything but YouTube.
Nothing has been of interest to me.
Yeah.
Or, like, well, I mean, the last show I watched was Game of Thrones when season whatever was on Xfinity. So, season 5 was on. And that was the last show I watched.
I was just curious.
I've actually, sometimes I go in the other room and I see my mom watching. I sit down and watch that show, The Strain, by.
I've heard that's really good.
What's his
Somebody
face?
At work keeps telling me to watch that.
I keep on forgetting who made it. It's the dude who was making. Del Toro, yeah. Yeah, Del Toro is the director.
Yeah. I've heard that's really
pretty
good.
Good from what I've seen. I've seen like a few. I've seen like half episodes of like the second season, and I mean, I didn't care that much, but I'm sure I'll forget everything that I saw if I go to watch it. But that it looks cool.
Cool.
Strain.
So yeah, mate, you should just hold off on watching too many new shows until I catch up, and then we'll start some other shows.
Yeah.
But yeah, I was curious, because I was like, I wonder if Eric's watching anything at the moment.
And also,
I know
about
you will
shows,
be when things come back.
Speaking about shows, I know we like talking about shows on here, but I feel like if someone just comes and watches this, and they only watch like one show of ours,
I feel like
we were like a spoiler cast.
We pretty much are. I think that we should replace that section and just talk about what we've been watching.
Yeah.
Like at the beginning, like we are now, but
you
know,
express
in the
our
correct
feelings.
Place.
I
just
see,
be like how awesome.
Express our
it is.
Feelings about it, but we don't like go full spoiler cast.
I mean, if we wanted to,
I feel like
spoiler
cast
video.
I mean, yeah. Like we could do that, but I feel like that's when we got a bigger following. But
I just enjoy talking about it. But it's we'll talk about it in our own time, and then we'll also just say like what we've been watching and you know an overview. That's what I was thinking. But so just don't watch many shows, and I'll catch up.
I'm just trying to focus on Destiny, honestly, because there's a lot of stuff to get prepared for the Taken King.
Same, but I've been slacking on TV, and I'm really enjoying it, you know. And that's what it's about. That's what it's about. Nate.
I had half the mind to sub to RuneScape again. I don't know why.
My gosh.
I saw like 3 Facebook posts about it, and I was like,
It keeps coming back to you.
At me. Hey.
That's how WildStar is for me. Also, my freaking posters look awesome in the camera. I noticed that.
Actually,
anyways.
I need new posters, and I might get frames soon.
Frames are the best. My idea worked out pretty much as I had planned. Where like there's 3 that are the same size, all with posters, and they look real uniform and good.
Yeah.
So, that WoW expansion, right?
Yeah, WoW expansion. when I was seeing, like, pictures of the new places and stuff, and, I mean, like, I was like, oh, yeah, this is cool. But then one thing, it popped in my head. Like, come on, you guys have the money. Just be like, okay, we're done. Now here is freaking a whole new game engine and completely new gameplay mechanics with sprinting.
I would like that, but they're never going to do it.
No, because this new expansion is still going to be playable on computers from 2003. So
pretty much. It's crazy. WoW expansion. Destiny!
Yeah.
We have like 10 minutes to talk about this now.
We got this, mate.
Yeah, but like, you know, I wish.
I mean, it's more of a list of stuff that we have to cover.
Yeah, let's just go over, but at the same time,
I have very strong opinions
on stuff.
Yeah,
I
get it.
You know what I mean? It's a bummer.
Does this link have all the stuff we need to know about?
It has most of the stuff, but either way, I know all of it. I remember all of it.
I mean, there's a lot of like specific ones though. I learned some more today, in fact.
So basically, let's just clarify this before we just go into all this stuff. Basically, Game Informer released a bunch of info. They are covering Destiny the month up until The Taken King. So they're covering Destiny this month, and they released, like, the article and stuff, and they're going to be releasing more at times. And so they had, like, a bunch of exclusive stuff, and they lined it up with Gamescom. So it released, like, the morning of Gamescom so that they could then show gameplay and do interviews and talk about all the stuff that was released. So I'm going to – so that is – it was just a lot of info about The Taken King. So that's pretty much what we're about to just go into.
Yeah.
I actually tweeted about the biggest news that happened that morning. So I'm going to find the ones that I think are huge. Okay. Let's just alternate. Biggest one. I'm going to start off with the biggest one. Ghost being recast by taking no more Peter Dinklage, Nolan North. All of Peter Dinklage's lines being redone by Nolan North. So Peter Dinklage will no longer be in the game, which I think is awesome. No offense. I mean,
Peter Dinklage is a good actor.
Come on, Dinklage. Nolan North is just a seasoned veteran in video games.
Yeah.
If he doesn't do well, I will be severely shocked. Everyone was shocked that Peter Dinklage didn't do well, but, like, he's not used to video games.
He's not a VO guy.
Yeah, and it's different. Like, if Nolan North's Ghosts come out and it's bad, everyone will be like, what the frick? What? So yeah, I highly doubt it. I mean, the lines are still going to be the same, so it's still going to be bad lines.
I feel like they might be tweaked a little. Yeah,
I hope so. But I don't...
With his personality and his...
Yeah.
I don't know.
His, you know, his ghost is going to be, like, different. Like, he's going to be talking differently and stuff, because Nolan North is going to put his own spin on it. He didn't even listen to Peter Dinklage's, acting.
Would probably, like...
Yeah. He said that... he purposefully said that he didn't want to listen to any of the person who did it before. He just wanted to do his own thing. So I'm freaking excited. That is what my... probably my top thing that I just cannot wait to hear. Like, if they release any sort of videos or whatever, I'm going to immediately just be like, where's the ghost? Give me some dialogue. But yeah.
Yeah.
Next.
I think my biggest thing, for me, besides that, that's probably the biggest thing right there. But another big thing, is quests and storylines for subclasses and exotics. That is really big for me because, I mean, every subclass,
like,
too.
Even, like, the older
you start
ones.
The game over. Just, I mean, crazy. Actually, we might still be able to do them. I don't
yeah,
know.
I hope so, but we might. So there's.
I mean,
that.
You might be able to pick them up from Cade 6.
Yeah.
Of those other two guys.
That's Ikora. One of the things that we don't know, but we're hoping.
But yeah,
we're hoping.
This also would go into my other thing that I'll just talk about this right now. It's very short, but they also released gameplay of the Sleeper Simulant, which is a exotic fusion rifle that is in the heavy slot.
I think that's really cool.
Yeah, it's really cool. So it's basically a railgun. But the thing about it is that you don't get it from just getting it. You have to go through multiple steps of finding pieces of, apparently, like, the war mine pieces, and you create it. You go through quests and you actually make the exotic weapon, which is really cool.
That's how lot of exotic weapons are supposed to happen. Yeah. This is one of the things they discuss. They discuss that they're building most of the rewards. They want you to feel like you earn them, i.e., the way that exotic quests are done now. They're trying to emulate that in a you know, similar way. They're trying to add more things as in quests. As in, like, you go here, you do this. Like,
faction quests.
Yeah, there's faction quests. There's lots of quests that we're going to be able to just do. Like, we're going to finish the story missions, and then we're going to have quests.
Mm-hmm.
That's like, go here, do this, you get this gun.
And I'm pretty sure the first thing when we get into awesome. The Taken King is, well, a cinematic, and then the first mission, and then we'll probably be prompted to do a subclass or a quest for the new subclasses.
Probably. Okay, I haven't been freaking out as much as, like, I thought I would, but it's basically because all of this is, like, too good to be true. So now that, the way you just put that, like, probably when we start up the Taken King, this will happen, I was like, frick. When we start up the Taken King, this will happen. As in, it's going to happen.
Cutscenes.
We're going dialogue. To get the Taken King. Like I said, this all sounded too good to be true, but now that I'm actually thinking about it, we're gonna get it. And we're gonna Nolan play
North.
It. We're gonna play it. It's gonna be a reality. I'm so excited.
Yeah. Awesome. And some other things about the updates to Taken King is like the RNG algorithm is gonna be different. Yep. So like if you have Gjallarhorn, you have a better chance at getting Fourth Horseman.
Yeah, something else.
In my case.
Oh, also Eric got the freaking Gjallarhorn.
Oh yeah.
Just tossing
yeah,
that out there.
I think we mentioned that.
We might have.
No. I don't remember, but I got Gjallarhorn.
Yeah, so GG. The RNG is supposed to change, as in it's supposed to read what you have and not give you as many duplicates, which is really cool. Really cool. One more thing that we forgot about the ghost. In the article where they were talking about the ghost, they also said, we have additional details about the ghost in this month's cover story, including ways in which the character now presents a new optional avenue into learning about Destiny's lore. So,
Metroid Prime style opt-in lore.
Talking about that. Let's talk about that. That's real cool.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. What else is here? Also, some people think that that might actually be, like, the way they worded that might just be in-game Grimoire. Like, your ghost might be able to just, like, open up a section that's like, there's everything. So we'll have to freaking learn about that.
Maybe Nolan North will
just pop
read
up.
The lore.
Yeah, that's what some people think.
That would
be
great.
The ghost will literally just pop up and, like, read stuff. Oh, that'd be dope. Let's see here. All of the original missions have been reorganized, contextualized, and placed within a larger quest framework. Even older subclasses have... Yeah, there's the subclasses.
That's why I
want to
redo the
game.
Quest.
Yeah, I don't... I want to as well, but at the same time, I really don't... like,
why
I want
not?
To... Because I don't have time to put in again. And I hated it last time. Hated it. My third time was awful. It's horrible. I'm so used to using all these exotic and legendaries, and when you're stripped down to whites and greens, you freaking feel it in your balls.
Yeah.
You feel it.
Although I would
it's
like
rough.
A crucible mode where you can only
I'll probably
have
just YouTube everything
without exotics. That'd be pretty interesting.
Be interesting. Let's see. What else are the biggest stuff? Equipable emotes.
Mm-hmm.
Let
yeah,
that
I
sink
actually,
in,
I actually,
boys and girls.
I know you told me about it the other day. Like, oh yeah, you can equip emotes, but I didn't know how. And I saw Dado's video.
It's just on your
character
screen.
It's actually in your
it's
character
right there.
Customization. It's right there.
Equipable emotes.
Like, what? So yeah, that's cool.
It's amazing. Cool. It's amazing. I'm so excited. This is a big conspiracy theory thing right here. Quests from the ominous Eris Morn lead to the rediscovery of a forgotten weapon type. That's a quote. But a lot of people have been taking a screenshot and looking down at the heavy slot, and the icon looks like a sword. So people are thinking maybe you get
you
a sword
this?
As your heavy ammo. It's not right here. I don't have the freaking source right now. I mean, I can find it, but that's what I've been seeing.
I need to see this, but okay.
Probably just go to Planet Destiny, their Twitter. Yeah. Let me go here right now. Scroll through. But yeah, so people are thinking it might be like the energy sword in Halo, whereas you only have a certain amount of hits and stuff. And then you have to pick up like heavy ammo and stuff, which would be really cool. I don't know how it would be in the Crucible though, but if that is actually a thing, that's just amazing. That's all I gotta say about that. What else? What else, Eric? Some other big stuff.
The gunsmith.
Oh my gosh. That's really cool.
And now you, to level up him, you grab these prototype weapons, use them, do the bounties on them. Like, if you get a sniper, the bounty that's attached to that weapon will be like, okay, get headshots with this weapon in the crucible. That's genius.
It's so good.
It gets you to try out new stuff.
And like, if you, yeah, like, if you do a certain set of, like, if you do, like, a certain quest, certain tasks, like, complete all the bounties or whatever, then you get a delivery of a weapon on Wednesday.
Yeah.
Like, on Arms Day, they call it, is awesome. Very, very cool.
It's kind of like,
some other big stuff.
Buying something off of Amazon, and it comes on Wednesday.
Yeah, dude! You're, like, excited for it to arrive? Oh, yeah. I'm down with that. Okay, big things. There's so much big stuff. Oh, tiers, as in intellect, discipline, and strength, will tell you seconds for your cooldown instead of percentages, which I think is really cool.
Also, have to wear the class item to gain reputation in a faction.
You can pledge allegiance. Pledge
and take missions and all that stuff.
Then you can wear whatever the crap you want.
And you can turn in unwanted material for reputation.
Yep.
All my spin metal. There you go. I have like 700 spin metal.
Really cool stuff.
No more emblems and shaders taking up vault space.
Yes. This is big.
Terminal by this the huge Eva Levant or whatever.
Yes. They're supposed to store all of the emblems and shaders that you have earned so far up to this point in the game.
Yep.
Which is...
So basically, it's kind of like in WoW, how you can, like, look at a list of all your mounts and
animals. Oh, man. It's
great.
Oh, boy. Oh!
You can change the displayed weapon in the tower just by pressing triangle or Y. Yep. That's awesome. That's I want to do that sometimes, honestly.
Yeah. Because sometimes it's just showing, like...
And if I want to pull up my
galloping, and it's like, what's going on here? I wonder if that's just random, you know, in general. I wonder if that's random, a random thing, as to what's shown.
I think it's the last thing you equipped.
Okay, it's interesting.
Yeah, there's a few exotics that were figured out, like the Jade Rabbit, the Sleeper Simulant, and No Time to Explain.
The Jade Rabbit is the exotic scout rifle for the PlayStation. No Time to Explain is an awesome name, is a pulse rifle, and it's a variant of the Stranger's rifle. It is confirmed, not totally sure. But I believe it's been confirmed that it is not actually made from your Stranger's rifle.
That would be pretty cool. Like,
it would have
the Stranger rifle.
It's supposedly not. That's what everyone thought originally that it would be. It would be like a Husk of the Pit type thing.
Yeah. I mean, that would be cool, but whatever.
I don't even have my Stranger's rifle, so I was glad.
I mean, you don't need... I'm sure if you didn't have your Stranger's rifle, there would be a way to get it back.
Yeah, somebody told me that you can run the Black Garden and sit through the cutscene and get it again. And I was like... Really? So I don't know. Maybe you can do that. What else?
Oh, there is also a exotic on the Dreadnought that is earned by fighting pieces of it all over. That's interesting.
The Dreadnought is going to have so many secrets. There's a public event that you can instigate yourself, as an a la zone boss, hopefully. That sounds dope.
All exotic unique perks are going to be automatically unlocked. So, like, Wolf Pack rounds on Gellhorn automatically unlocked.
I think that's good. Same 14.
Eight new maps and three new modes.
Eight new maps is awesome.
Three new modes.
Four new strikes.
Yep. Narrative driven.
Some strikes are going to be reworked and changed so that they're a little bit, they have the Taken in them, and they'll switch out with enemies and stuff, which is awesome. Right. They'll have different narrations at the beginning, which is cool.
Right. Shows you the Taken. But yeah.
Taken phones.
Gonna be good.
Man. I wish we could have talked about that more, but freaking.
I mean, also, I heard something about the dark blade fight is gonna be in a pitch black room. So basically, you have to use abilities and stuff that have
light that you see. Show light in the room. I don't know. I can't wait. Also, found the picture of the sword. Been looking this whole time. Just found it. There is so much stuff. The quest system is honestly huge.
It really is. And also, you don't have to turn in bounties at the tower. You can do it. All your bounties and quests and stuff can be done right there. I mean, it's the 30th century. Come on.
It's the 30th century. Come on, what are you doing? That's funny. Big stuff for Destiny fans. Get freaking ready.
I think if it's going to be like this, I honestly think we're just not going to I don't think the next Destiny game is going to be like Destiny 2. It'll be just more, but I feel like the next Destiny like release thing
I was about to say the next Destiny game will be Destiny 2.
I don't think it's going to be called Destiny 2, obviously, because
subtitle, but I bet it might be Destiny 2 : something. That's possible.
I don't think that, because I feel like
they might
do it for Destiny 2.
Yeah.
I don't know, because I know I am like 99% sure that Destiny 2 will be on next gen only. So
I really hope so. If not, that's a little bit
crazy.
Yeah.
A little crazy.
Let me send you this sword picture so that you can then be like, oh yeah, that's that. Here it is.
If it is going to be on next gen only, then they need to tell people soon, because I mean,
yeah,
they'll like upgrade.
They'll probably do it at E3 like they did this year, which to be honest is enough time. It's like they announced it like House of Wolves. They announced like a month before or like a month and a half before, and then they announced Taken King like 3 months before. I was like, oh well, I'm down with that.
Yeah,
but I just thought that was interesting that it's like a lot more time. But you know, it's as we've seen, it is a way bigger thing. There is so much going into this.
This is like basically a giant. When I was going to buy Taken King, they actually mentioned Dark Below and House of Wolves as episodes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, and they're looking at this as more of a
expansion
sequel.
And betterment.
They're in the Fireteam chat episode with Deej and one other guy from Bungie. I can't remember his name.
Luke.
They were talking about how Fran was asking about prices and value, and one guy just flat out was like, well, I mean, if you're talking about straight up content, this has well over twice as much as The Dark Below or House of Wolves, like over. So just from all of that, there's a lot of stuff.
Right.
Of stuff going on. Man. Get hyped.
So yeah.
I'm gonna go eat, and then we're gonna go play Trials of Osiris so that we can get really ready. Yeah, I got it up. I'm gonna have cereal for dinner, and it's gonna be great, and we're gonna go flawless, and it's gonna be great.
Yemen.
The map in Black Ops 2 and Uncharted 3! Speaking of Uncharted, you gotta pre-order the Uncharted collection, mate. After Gears of War, that's gotta... Check. Yeah, Gears of War, and then Uncharted. That's gotta be the way to go. So...
I almost pre-ordered Everybody's Gone the Rapture.
Yeah, I'm thinking of it. I saved money. As you saw on the upcoming games list, that's one... let me find it. That is one of the ones that I am... games that I need to keep an eye on and maybe get. So I'm going to look at reviews.
I'm going to wait until I see some reviews.
Yeah, if that game's reviewed really highly, I'm like, heck yes.
Because definitely. I know what it's going to be. It's going to be a really story-driven Chinese room. Chinese Room did Machine... Oh, gosh, what is it? Machine for Pigs, Amnesia 2.
Yeah.
It wasn't like a very scary or horrific game like the first one, but it was very, 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 very story driven and psychological. So I could see that being another thing here. I mean, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't what I expected.
Yeah.
But this is, I'm expecting a story driven.
Yeah, just a narrative first person exploration thing. So yeah, if it's getting really high reviews, I'm definitely throwing down that $15-$20.
Right. The thing is, apparently when you pre-order it, you get a theme.
Yeah. Yeah, it's like, oh, those themes, mate, they're bringing you in. It's like those amiibos. Yeah.
It's amiibos.
It's amiibos, but on the PS4. Brian Clements over here, PlayStation Powerhouse, over on The Drop.
The Drop, it looks like it got a little overhaul now.
Yeah, he said in the comments, happy Sunday, what do you think of the new format? Cheers.
Brian Clements, I think it's interesting.
I honestly liked that there was a picture with each
game,
but this is cool.
Links. He is the Ebd.
Yeah, it's fancy-looking text right here. It's fancy. And it's a really good looking, like, it
looks
takes
like an
up
article. It looks like a real article.
Yeah, it like takes up space. You know, it's, yeah. Let's go through this. For the uninitiated, this is the time where we end the show. But first, we go over the PlayStation Drop that Ryan Clements, the PlayStation Powerhouse, goes over. He puts it up every Sunday. And it's basically all of the games coming out on the PlayStation ecosystem on that Tuesday or that week. For rare occasions, such as The Order and other games that come out on not Tuesdays because they're weird. So yeah, here it is. Actual Sunlight for the PS Vita. Widely considered to be one of the bleakest experiences in indie gaming. Okay. Actual Sunlight challenges you to confront the life of Evan Winter, an overweight, lonely, and severely depressed young professional. Presented almost entirely in text, a mixture of sharp observation and pitch-black humor captures your interest from provocative beginnings to shattering conclusion. That seems interesting. I'm going to keep an eye on that. Also, look at this next game, Eric.
Yeah.
Heck
Brothers,
yeah.
Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons.
Heck yeah. I loved Brothers. Brothers was awesome.
Apparently you controlled each brother with a different stick. Is that right?
Yes.
It's really interesting.
Amazing. It's really good. I was just about to say, if you're somebody who owns a PS4 and didn't own or haven't played Brothers: The Tale of Two Sons, freaking buy this game and play it. And apparently you're one of them. So buy this game and play it. It's really good. I bet it's about, my guess for on the store, it's probably $15. That's my guess. There's also Commander Cherry's Puzzle Journey for the PS4. Yoga action platformer. Just let that sink in. Yoga action platformer.
Yoga. Okay.
All
right, and then of course everybody's gone the Rapture.
Yep.
This Tuesday.
Right here.
The same guys who made Deresser, and they helped with Amnesia 2 as well. So yeah.
It's about the apocalypse.
Deresser was very convoluted, I'll say that. But it was still good. It was still good.
So this Gauntlet Slayer edition for PS4.
This looks kind of cool.
Looks like a little Diablo co-op shooter, you know, turn sick dungeon crawler. Looks cool. Looks like cool art style too. Look at this picture right here, people. Looks kind of cool.
Yeah.
All right, going back. So yeah, look into that. It might be good.
Oh my gosh.
It's like the tagline for The Drop.
All right. Goat Simulator.
For PS4 and PS3.
It's here, guys.
It's here, the long-awaited Goat Simulator. Honestly,
this game has gone from a stupid little thing on Steam to like a full-fledged.
Now it's on Xbox One and PS4.
Thing.
Gosh. Yep. Gosh dang it. Kung Fury Street Rage. PS4. So just, you know what? I don't even want to read that.
Wait, isn't this based off of that one short
that
those YouTubers did?
It's a movie. Kung Fury is a movie.
Yeah.
Kung Fury is a crowdfunded movie based off of 80s style karate movies. So yeah.
Yeah.
I guess it's based off of that. I don't really know.
Did you see that?
No, but it's free on Steam. So anyone can if they want to.
I mean, like, wait, what?
It's free on it's free on Steam, mate.
What? It was released?
Yeah, it's been released.
It was actually released. What?
Yeah, a while ago.
I saw the trailer like when it was released, and it had David Hasselhoff, and I haven't seen this yet.
It's free on Steam, so yeah, which is weird. On
YouTube as well.
You know what? I saw this last freaking. I saw this under pre-orders when I was looking through pre-orders. I want to talk about this. They were just sneaking this in. Prototype and Prototype 2. Just releasing
and
on PS4.
And Prototype 1.
Well, I said Prototype and Prototype 2.
Yeah.
But, like, they're just like, there it is. And honestly, last week, I thought they were out. So it was like, oh. Nah, I don't know. That would be weird if it wasn't. That would be very weird. It might be. You never know. So yeah, if you like Prototype, there you go.
Random. They didn't even like say, "Hey, Prototype 2 and 1 collection thing on."
Yeah, they didn't hype it up at all. Anyways.
Oh, great. We got Space Hulk.
You know what? Just think about that. Think about Mark Ruffalo jumping around in space. All right.
Wait, actually, it's apparently the Warhammer 40K universe stuff. I've heard that stuff is pretty good, so I don't know much about it, but there's that.
All right.
Torque
L for PS4 and Vita cross-buy. Torque up, head on, roll, tumble, and extend to get over magma, high walls, and a myriad, Colin would be proud, of other obstacles in this puzzle game. There you go. Torque L. Unique 2D rolling and extend platformer action puzzle game. All right, then.
All right. Toy Soldiers, War Chest, Battle for the Booty.
All right. X-Blaze, Lost Memories, also Battle for the Booty. And that has been the drop. And also, for the uninitiated, we also... Oh, it's going to go back to this. We also show one random thing at the end of the podcast every week. Why? I don't know. Because why not?
Yeah.
Because we got random things to show. You'll like it. So, we actually don't fully have anything. I have something, actually, if you don't.
I mean, I technically already showed what I was going to show.
You got Halo.
But it was basically, like, integrated into it. I will show you. I do have something, actually.
There's always something new. Like, we always have something.
All right. Yeah, I got something. I have... I'm just gonna say this. My hand is on fire right now.
Oh no!
I also have the only Diablo sauce packet left in the universe.
Thanks,
probably
son.
Probably not true.
You're gonna get hunted down. They're gonna come for you. Somebody's like, I heard that it's been located.
They're not making these anymore. Oh, I'm just gonna keep this as a trophy. Yeah.
There you go. I wish my phone had just went ding and done the trophy sound. Anyways, that would have been perfect. So there you go. Go out to your local Taco Bell and get your Diablo sauce before it's gone.
It's already gone.
All right. Get your fire
been
sauce.
Gone four
Moving
months.
On. Get your fire
it's been
sauce.
Gone 4 months.
I don't care. Dude, I don't freaking... They're like, you want sauce? No. And then I drive off.
Oh, I say fire. I just collect the fire in case I need more fire sauce for the future.
I can't, no.
And I have the sauces laying here all the time in case I get more Taco Bell.
No, I ain't about that. I ain't about Taco Bell sauce. It's too hot.
You haven't tried it.
It's too hot.
Fire
it's cold
is
fire.
Hot. Fire isn't hot. Diablo is hot.
It's cold fire.
Dude, you can cool it down just with like one drink.
Question, do you like spicy food? In general, just like
spicy
usual,
food or
not
spicy
sauce. Spicy stuff. Sauce.
I mean,
sometimes food.
I don't like stuff where I'm like dying, but like, I like spicy sauce that tastes good. So like, sometimes I like spicy wing sauce, habanero sauce on potatoes.
Then that fire sauce is hot. I hate to break it to you, it's hot. But for the uninitiated. It's hot. Me, I don't eat spicy food at all. So that would be hot for me. That'd be rough. I'd be like...
No, this is hot. This is like...
No, that would literally kill me. Eric, You're talking to a kid.
You haven't tried it, so you don't.
Eric, you're talking to a kid who took you know those peppers that you put on pizza that like are at pizza places, yes, like next, yes, to the Parmesan, you know? Yes,
I know.
I put two of those.
Those are gross.
Two little pieces on one bite.
Yeah.
Bit it, drank four glasses of water because I was dying and sweating.
Why would you drink water? That would make it worse.
That's not true at all. Water doesn't.
Yeah.
It doesn't help much, but it doesn't make it worse.
It does because it spreads around the.
Well, I'm sorry that I was at a chemicals CC's buffet who don't serve milk.
But yeah, those things are hot. Those things are definitely hot.
I don't like those.
So.
Yeah, I was dying. So yeah. Also, though,
these are nothing like that. No, these are tame. These are like medium. This is like medium salsa at.
That's usually Mexican. Pretty hot for me. That's usually pretty rough. Like, that's hot. Like, mild sauce to me is hot, usually.
We've been talking about salsa for 5 minutes on this podcast.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm proud of that right there.
The title of this podcast is going to be salsa.
It's like two of the new stuff. It's like Destiny the Taken King.
Salsa.
Xbox at Gamescom and salsa.
Yep.
All right.
Do it.
Well, right. Let me know in the comments if you're. I don't know. I want to know your opinions on this salsa thing.
Yeah.
I'm curious. I might have to just try it myself. But
yeah, I mean,
this is a thing. I was getting used to spicier stuff because every Saturday, you probably know this. I used to go to Oscar's Taco Shop every Saturday and get freaking two tacos and chips and salsa until they changed their freaking salsa. It's not the same salsa anymore. It's completely different. And it's like three times as hot. And it was already pretty hot. But I was getting used to the spiciness because I was like eating it every week. So I was like, it's getting better. Like, it wasn't even that bad by the end of, like, you know, 2 or 3 months of eating the salsa every week. But I also haven't eaten anything spicy since. Like, nothing. So
yeah.
I'm probably back to my state of
goodness. When it comes to spicy stuff, I'm like, okay, I like spicy stuff that tastes good as well.
That's why I like that gosh dang salsa. It tastes
really good. Tastes good. It's, like, sweet or very flavorful, but it has a kick to it as well. That's why I like this sauce, because it's like sweet and really tasteful and nice, but then my face gets like red and my eyes start like tearing up. The elbow sauce. Okay,
well, you know what, Eric, next time I go to Taco Bell, I will force myself. When he goes,
You will need a drink.
Okay. When he goes, do you want any sauce? I'll have to just be like, you know what, sir? Give me some of that fire. He'll toss it in the car, and I'll be like, yeah. And I'll roll out with my rap music playing. All right. See you next week. See you next week. Eat salsa.